presence. We need more of His power. We need more of His word. All of our churches would be more concerned with God showing up. And so you are free with much freedom. Number two, the burnout cycle. Here's how the burnout cycle every Christian knows about the burnout cycle. Why? Because it is pretty much the way it goes in Christianity in America today. You sign up for 10 ministry teams. There's no time to spend with God as Lord. Churches have been so concerned and so small-minded. America. Look, you're around the world, the fields are white for harvest, but we don't have the vision to go and get them. We don't have the vision. We don't have the desire. We're like, you part of what God is doing. He's preparing the church for such a time as this. I'm talking about the Samuel Spirit that God is pouring out. This Spirit represents the Spirit of pure, true ministry. He starts with this. Church ministry is primarily ministry. scar will be laid bare, and he will say, surely God is upon you. That's why we call the exegesis. Don't be discouraged as the bad prophecies you've heard in the past. You need to understand, we've been in our infancy in these things. I always point out Ring Square. You guys know Ring Square? You guys see here back in the day, okay, back in the day, would you let me have my vineyard? Thank you. great themselves in this hour. The Lord gave us the word. He said, ask for 10. He will give 10. And in response to that word, we are launching an internship in this next season for Praise and Prayer. Some of you feel a burden from God. I must be intimate with Him. I feel like I'm to get away and to give Him 10 hours a week. And I want to say, if you feel like that is you, I would like you to consider and pray about joining our internship. It is going to launch at the beginning of March. Some of you, like I said, have those types of things at your own church. Some of you guys come from churches where they do morning prayer. Some of you have your own houses of prayer. Some of you have super anointed prayer closets. God bless you. Wherever it is that you meet with God, we want you to dig in that place where God has called you and to consecrate yourself in this hour and prioritize intimacy with Jesus. If you feel like God is burdening your heart for what's going on in Praise and Prayer, I want to give you a couple details. Tonight we're releasing applications. What's it going to look like? You're going to ask for 2 to 4 sets a week. That's 4 to 8 hours in the prayer room at Praise and Prayer. You can do it on your own schedule. And then for 2 hours a week, we're going to meet on Saturdays, and we are going to train and fellowship together. That's what we believe, is that God is calling forth a company of people who will go deep in their intimacy in this season. Let me tell you how anointing works. If you give God 8 hours, you give Him the time when you set yourself apart and you seek His face. What happens is you go through your life and search to grow. Your worship starts to touch you more deeply. Your prayer starts to touch you more deeply. That's how it works. That's what I'm saying. If you feel like that's you, we're going to have you for 2 years today and you can come and talk to us. Today we're making a call, and I just feel like it's not just for Praise and Prayer. I feel like this is something that God is doing all over this region. I say it again, there's dozens of houses of prayer that I feel like God is going to raise up in the season of the church. I want to encourage you right now. How many of you feel like you have a musical gift? Just raise your hand right now. You have a musical gift. Come on, this is your gift. Come on, put it up. Musical gift. Thank you.